shadowy world that hides more than half the animals on our planet. Until now, cameras only offered a glimpse into their lives. But with next-generation technology, we can see the night. As clear as day.
This is Kiyra Lynn with Hollywood First Look, and today I'm sitting down with Tom Hugh-Jones, executive producer of Tiny World, and Alex Williamson, executive producer of Earth, Night, and Color, and we're going to talk about their docu-series, both streaming on Apple TV Plus now. Both of you have extensive experience in filmmaking of this kind, and I'd love to know, what makes nature as a subject fascinating to each of you? Tom, I'll start with you.
I think they say that a fact is stranger than fiction. And if you look to the natural world, it's just an endless source of wonder and inspiration. And I think at a time these days when most people don't get out to see much of the wilderness and it's much harder for people to connect with nature, wildlife films have a really special place in modern society. They enable people to see the wonders of the world when they can't travel or they can't afford to travel. And more than that, I think they help people realize just how precious it is and how kind of quickly it's disappearing. So it's a really powerful tool in trying to help people come to think about how they can live in more harmony with the natural world.
Yeah, well, for me, the natural world is just perfection. And I started my career actually filming people and I came to nature a little later, and it just felt like a revelation for me. And it felt, however you film it, it looks beautiful. And you film a dragonfly landing on a leaf, or you film a cheetah kind of patrolling the grassland. It's the aesthetic of the natural world for me is what totally motivates me. And it just is such a mind-blowing beauty to it. But then you look at the complexity of it and how it works and how it all fits together and the wonder of evolution, and it feels like a great story to be telling. I think David Attenborough, who's one of our kind of ultimate kind of heroes in this country, was once asked, when did you get into nature? And his response was to the journalist, when did you stop?
Some of the opening sequences in the episodes are so precise and so colorful that for a moment I actually felt like I was just watching some really extensive and illustrious animation. I would love to know, out of all of the world captured in your series, what was the one that was the most exhilarating for you?
I think for me the most exhilarating was the Caribbean islands. I hadn't quite appreciated it, but Caribbean islands are home to a lot of the smallest animals on the planet. They have the smallest bird, the smallest lizard, the smallest snake. And it was somewhere people don't often go to for wildlife films. It's probably because there aren't many big animals there. But when we went to look at the micro world, it was really rich. And then it's all set against this backdrop of these huge hurricanes that sweep in every year. So we had this really kind of dramatic force that was coming to get our tiny little heroes and that they had to fight against. So it was a real revelation for me, and especially the little hermit crab that does his housing chain and swaps shells. I think, you know, very few people know that goes on, and it's such a wonderful example of collaboration in the natural world.
Well, Alex, let's talk about some of the technology used in your series. What I really appreciated was at the tail end, it talked about, you know, how difficult it was for the team to actually capture some of those sequences. What was, you know, talk to me about the learning curve and ultimately knowing when you got it right.
Yes, there was a very steep learning curve. And when we first pitched the idea, it was this ludicrous idea of shooting an entire series in the pitch black at night. And when we got cracking, and the first shoot we did actually was down to the Pantanal in Brazil to try and film jaguars, and say try and film, because we learned a lot very rapidly. Basically, the technology was pushing the technology right to the limit, and these cameras shoot at night in color, but only for a few nights each month around the full moon, for about 4 or 5 nights either side of a full moon, when there's enough moonlight for them to get an exposure. So we had this crazy schedule of bouncing different teams simultaneously to different locations around the world, Australia, Brazil, the high Arctic, to try and film in these precious full moon windows. And at the start, there's a very fine tightrope between getting it and not quite getting it. And if you get a storm cloud, a storm system which blows in for a few nights over full moon, that's the entire shoot completely wasted.
Tiny World and Earth at Night in Color are currently streaming on Apple TV Plus. My name is Kiyra Lynn, and you're watching Hollywood First Look.
Four independently acting wings and articulated bodies allow for extraordinary aerobatics and high-speed maneuvers in nature's ultimate dogfight.